So I'm holding the tool we just ground here, and I've inspected it on our Zola measurement machine behind us, and I can see that it's not quite perfect and we need to make a few corrections. Luckily, I've got Santosh here, who's one of our product managers here at ANCA. He used to be an applications engineer and he's got extensive experience in our R&D grinding center. He's ground thousands of these things and using many different versions of our software on many different machine platforms. So he's gonna help us correct this tool today. Welcome, Santosh.
Thanks, you.
No worries. The first thing I can see on this tool is that the start of the gash plane is not quite where I programmed it. I was expecting to see the start of the gash plane 0.1 millimeters in from the OD ball transition, but it's about 0.3 millimeters at the moment. How do you think I could correct this?
So I can see that you've used the facet gash method. So we have a couple of methods to grind the gash. There's a curvature method, which probably we'll cover in the next few episodes. But looking at the facet gash method, the first and the foremost is checking your web thickness.
Sure.
So what is web thickness? It is the distance from the center of the tool to your gash tip. And sometimes for this tool, perhaps you might have programmed 0.3 millimeter or something like that. But that is determined by your back face of your grinding wheel.
Right.
Once you're happy with that, once you check it, okay, I've programmed it 0.3, and it is measuring 0.3, this means your back face of your wheel is in the correct position.
Okay.
Well done, fantastic. But even then, you have the same distance error. That would be because of your the rotation of your tool.
Okay, and so how do I correct that?
So there is a parameter, there's a couple of ways to do it, but the most recommended method is to use the A offset parameter.
Right.
What that does is, it actually rotates the tool into the grinding wheel, positive or negative. In your case, you're telling me that the distance is longer, which means there is more material to be removed.
Sure.
So I would recommend to give a negative value, which will make the tool into the grinding wheel.
Sure.
And more material is removed, therefore your distance is also okay, as per program.
So we'll be pushing our gash plane further back toward the OD ball transition.
Absolutely right. Towards the transition point. And one good way I always tell our users to do it is just put a large value in the A offset parameter and see what happens. Put a 5 degree and you can literally see a huge change before you make a correction on your wheel adjustment page or A offset page,
right. So wherever that is. So you're using our simulator.
Absolutely.
Right, yeah. So offline, make large changes to a parameter and you can see the effect on the geometry. That's
exactly.
That's a good tip.
Yeah, that's it, yep.
All right, so the other thing I noticed when I was inspecting this tool is some facets along the gash plane. Do you know what this could be and how we could fix it?
Okay, so the facets on the gash plane, of course, we have used the facet method, but this facet is we call them as generally chatter. Now, chatter in a general term could be something loose somewhere, or it could be inefficient cutting. Okay. Inefficient grinding.
Well, I think the mechanical setup we took care when we were setting that up. We made sure our wheel pack was tight and our work holding was functioning correctly. So I think we can rule that out.
Yeah, okay.
So what else do you think could be causing this chatter?
So when I say inefficient cutting, I'm talking about two things here. One is the actual grinding wheel itself. And the second thing is your grinding process parameters.
Sure.
So let's talk about the grinding wheel itself. Number one, is your wheel dressed flat and sharp? This is the back face, which is doing the job. And the second thing is it running true? That's another thing to take care of. And of course, if it is loaded, it might require some kind of a sticking, so you can actually open up the fresh grains.
Right.
Now, coming to the process parameters, again, there are a couple of things here. One is the cutting speed. Is your cutting speed too harsh? Are you running this wheel at a very high RPM, which is making the wheel run harder, which means you can end up not cutting, but more rubbing.
Right.
Plus, the other thing is your feed rate. Are you being too aggressive?
Sure.
Allow the grains to remove the material. In some cases, you might need to split it into a roughing and a finishing gash operation.
Right.
And the last thing is, I would say, have a closer look at your grinding wheel specification. A too finer grade may not be required.
Yep.
As long as you are able to choose a medium grade, for example, a D54, or a D46 should be okay for tools less than 12 millimeter.
Great.
There's no point in putting a D10 or a D15 on a 12 millimeter tool.
Sure.
So there are a few things here, and it is quite a bit of a trial and error, but these are the areas to look in, and if you can focus, you will get rid of the first marks.
So making sure your wheel is dressed true, it's open and sharp.
Yep.
That you've got the correct wheel specification, and that your feeds and speeds are correct.
Absolutely. Great. Yeah, and that should be fine. Yep.
Great. The other thing I noticed when I was inspecting this tool is that the outside diameter is not exactly as I programmed it. It's slightly undersized. Okay. So how can I adjust that and give myself the correct OD?
The simple thing is, now I can see you've done a facet primary relief on the OD, and that is done by using the cup wheel, and you're using the front face of the cup wheel at an angle of maybe 3 or 4 degrees.
Yep.
Now, primarily, the front face of the cup wheel is responsible. The position of that is responsible for the OD of the cutting tool. Now, if your OD is not correct, that means it is deviated from the nominal.
Mm-hmm.
The best thing to do is go to your wheel editor, and under the compensation tab, you just click on OD, and you just answer a simple question. What is your actual OD? Enter the value, and the compensation mechanism will automatically adjust the error, and the next tool, you'll be back to normal.
Right.
It's simple as that. Now, if you want to, if you're an experienced user and you want to directly go and adjust the value by yourself, you can go into the cup wheel and onto the adjustments tab and make a compensation on the front face.
Right, so we could adjust the front face or the diameter of the wheel independently.
Independently.
Okay, or we can let the actual software itself determine what it needs to compensate in order to give us the right size.
Exactly. That's exactly what happened. Yep.
I have a more general question for you now, Santosh. Is there a best practice in terms of arranging the operations in our tool file? Like which one should go first and which one's last?
Okay, so what you're asking there is, so we have the flute from solid operation, and then we have the plunge yield clearance, and then we have the ball gash?
Yeah.
Okay. So the way I look at it is always keep your finishing cycles towards the end of the cycle.
Right.
So when I say finishing cycle, I mean the ones which are responsible to form your cutting edges.
Okay.
For example, your OD primary, your ball primary.
Sure.
Gash as well.
Yep.
And in other words, do your high material removal rates operation at the beginning, flute from solid, for example. Why do I say this? The way I approached it is that the tool can deflect. It'll have some amount of deflection, how much ever your fluting is efficient.
Right.
We want to have a relaxed position of the blank when you're doing the cutting edges, and that's why I recommend to keep it at the end of the cycle.
Okay, great. And speaking of finishing operations, I noticed in my tool file, when I opened the OD ball finish operation, there were three different methods to choose when grinding the OD and ball. Can you explain each of these methods and when I should use each one?
Okay, so we're talking about the grind method related to the ball profile.
Right.
So we have three methods, the four-axis method, the five-axis method, and the fixed grind point method.
Right.
Now, ANCA is very strongly recommending us to always use fixed grind point method. So let me talk about the fixed grind point method a little bit here. So the FGP, or the fixed grind point method, is a five-axis method, but by using that method, you will have the best possible profile accuracy on your ball.
Right.
The reason is, in this particular method, if you can imagine a toroid radius on your cup wheel, there is a point around this, on the toroid where throughout the ball, that circle or a semicircle is used. You're not deviating across, and therefore your ball profile is good.
So you're not rolling around the toroid, and if your toroid is imperfect, you get an imperfect profile.
Exactly right,
okay.
Now, but why do we need five axis and the four axis? There are some special applications. So four axis is generally used for cutting tools which are micro tools. So perhaps maybe two or below in diameter.
Sure.
That's where the four axis is used. And five axis is used in special cases where your number of flutes are high and you have you want to control your oblique angle.
Right.
Where you want to see your grain lines on your cutting edges, not normal to the cutting edge. So there are some special cases where you want to use that. But always, we recommend to use the fixed grind point method, because that's where you will get, number one, good profile accuracy, and number two, a very good control of your wheel wear.
Great. I also noticed in the OD ball operation that I can choose to grind the OD and ball all in one pass, or I can grind the OD and ball separately. Can you tell me when I would use each case?
It's a very interesting question there. As you can see on this particular tool, you have done the facet OD and facet ball.
Right.
So it was a continuous straight line and an arc. But there are some cutting tools, ball nose tools, where the OD is not a facet relief. It's an eccentric relief. And that's when you need to split the operations.
Right, because we're grinding with a different wheel or?
Correct.
Okay.
So the wheel which is used to do the eccentric, which is probably we need to cover in the upcoming episodes. So the eccentric OD does the OD of the tool, and then you bring your cup wheel to do your facet relief on the ball.
Okay.
Now there are some cases where we can also see if you want to regrind the ball only. Okay, you want to keep pushing the ball in because that's the only portion being used.
But you don't want to touch the OD.
That's the OD.
Okay.
You can just do the ball as well.
Sure.
And that's why that flexibility is given for regrinding operations.
Right.
Yeah.
That makes sense. My final question is, I noticed in the main page of the tool file, in the cutting edge tab, there are numerous ball types. Can you please explain the different ball types and what their application is?
I'll elaborate the topic a bit more here. So we have seen ball tip geometry evolve over the years. Now, this is due to the complexity in manufacturing, the invention of new materials, and the customers want the tools to be high performance, easy to manage the chips, so chip management, and they want a vibration-free cutting. There are so many other factors, and the tool design is becoming more and more complex.
Right.
So we had to provide customers a very easy option to suit their customers' requirement of ball tip.
Okay, so to provide more flexibility when
more
designing
flexibility.
Their ball tip.
Exactly. So you can see in the ball type here, we have the OD lead, we have the ball lead, and then we have the helix option, but we also have something called as a designer cutting edge as well.
Sure.
So the first three will give you some features, okay, to an extent, but the designer is just opens up a world of possibilities. And
right.
You can just drag the tip however you want, and you can form the cutting edge the way you desire. And that is becoming more and more popular now. And our customers are given the option to design their own cutting edge rather than we defining it. They can define their own cutting edge.
Right.
And that's the beauty of it.
Okay, so if we want to go simple, we can use the existing options, but we now have this designer cutting edge.
Exactly right.
Which provides complete flexibility on
Absolutely.
What the geometry is.
Exactly right.
Well, thanks a lot for joining us today, Santosh. You've given us lots of information that hopefully our viewers can put into practice and improve their grinding. So thanks again.
Yep, thanks for having me. Thank you.
All right. That's our episode for today. Thanks a lot for joining us. Hope you picked up some tips or tricks. Something to help you improve your grinding. I also want to say a special thanks to Tyrolit today for providing the grinding wheels and Piranha, the coolant pipes. I also want to mention that we have lots of other instructional content that we're putting out alongside ANCA Academy. We've got our Tooltip Tuesday coming out every week and also the ANCA e-news every month. So make sure you check those out. The final thing I want to speak about today is the ANCA shop. We have got the ANCA shop up and running. Available for purchases only for people in America. So if you're in America, feel free to jump on and check out the accessories, software, tooling. There's lots of things on there, so make sure you have a look. And for the rest of the world, you can view the shop. Purchases aren't available yet, but they are coming. So that's it for today. Thanks a lot for joining us. I'll see you next time.